This horse farm is like nothing we've seen before. Set among these Swiss mountains, there is so much technology here. Horses have ID collars, there's automatic feeders customised for each horse, and when that food comes out of the back of them, it's all sucked away. Powered by Victron and automated by Node Red, this is about as high tech as it can get.
A farm needs a lot of power. If we need to grow, we can grow.
And with the help of Victron Energy, the farm owners are overcoming these challenges and growing both as a business and as an energy generator. Nestled near the Reggie Mountains, southeast of the Swiss city of Basel, is the Reggieberg Horse Farm, a mixed-use 12-hectare site combining horse livery and riding school with group exercise facilities. The farm is home to around 40 horses, ponies and donkeys. Ingeniously, roughage is fed individually to each horse using a modern automated feeding system.
My father was a dairy farmer, so we had 20 cows. We had a lot of horses for the work at the beginning, of course, and then the tractors are coming, and then we had the horses for the free time, so we go riding and so. And then we switch, or we specialize to a horse farm. Now my brother have like a horse hotel, so he have own horses and horses from other owners, and he care about this horse.
I grew up here with my brother and my sister. I took over the family farm 25 years ago. My brother started 25 years ago a computer company, and so we're happy both today.
Danny was originally going to take over the then dairy farm and learn the trade from his parents. He earned pocket money each summer picking cherries from the orchard, money which he decided to put to good use.
With this money I got from the cherries, I bought the first computer. It was an Atari. So with 11, I start learning the computing. And so I start computing. I was working in a company beside the farm. And I had a caravan here in my garden. But the problem was there was no electricity. So I was wondering how I solved the problem that I get my morning coffee, and I was researching by the internet how I get an off-grid. And then my first meeting with Victron system.
Danny solved the problem of his morning coffee by installing a small Victron Energy system into his caravan, comprising a 24-volt multi-plus with three solar panels on the roof, and soon began to see the wider potential for the farm of getting its power from the sun.
If it works in a small system, it must be also work in a bigger system. And so I met Markus from Germany, because I saw in the internet he do a lot of farms in Germany. So I contact him and say, hey, I have a farm in Switzerland from my brother, and I have the goal to make an off-grid system for the farm of my brother. And so I start deeply into this Victron system, and I find out that the big one of Multiplus and so on, they work properly, and we plan the whole thing with Markus Weisbach from Germany together, and I build it here in Switzerland.
Having brought German installer Markus on board to oversee the installation of a full Victron Energy storage system, they first needed to understand and quantify the energy needs and consumption of the business.
If you have a dairy farm, you need the power in the morning and in the evening, and of course during night also. The farmer is milking at the morning, at the evening. Victron understood we have to create a system that then there we can use the power when we need it. And this is the fascination of me, that we can use the power in the morning and in the evening because we have batteries and the system. Markus Weisbach told me this, what I have to calculate, what I have to looking for, and that we know where are the peaks, and the peaks will give us the results or the answers which kind of system we need.
In this barn we have a kind of vacuum machine to put the manure out.
The machines use 12 to 15 kilowatts to run and are much more efficient than the traditional method of shovel and wheelbarrow. And after all, nobody likes shoveling shit.
In the morning, we clean the barn, we push the manure to these four points, and then we start the motor. And then it takes around 20 to 25 minutes to take all the manure out.
A key factor to consider was the automated systems used to feed the horses 24 hours a day and also to dry their hay.
This is the computer, and every horse we feed six times a day, and every horse gets individual time in minutes. It works really great. I cannot imagine that how we did it before. Without this, we have this computer system for 5 years. Each horse has a chip here inside, this yellow little chip. And when they walk in, the computer checks the chip. It sees, okay, this horse is allowed now. Then we open the door. No, this horse is not allowed. Then the door stays closed.
Several residential flats on site also require power, 2 to 3 kilowatts, constantly through the night. It was then simply a matter of doing some maths to ensure there were enough panels on the roof to charge the batteries to provide enough power for use through the night.
It was clear with 30 kilowatts in three phases, we are fine. Because there is not dairy stuff like cooling of milk and so on. So here was clear, the peak told us it's enough if we have 30 kilowatts. But we have a lot of roof space and we can also feed the grid and we can earn some money from the grid feed. So our goal was build a system. We have the whole night enough energy with the batteries. And through the day, the peaks we can send to the electricity company back. So we earn here in Switzerland nearly 15 cents per kilowatt.
With this goal in mind, they've installed 29 solar panels on the stable roof, capable of producing 10.73 kilowatt peak, plus 125 panels on the main building, producing 46.7 kilowatt peak. As they did this installation themselves, the roof was heat scanned to check if there were any hot spots or faulty panels.
You need a lot of panels on the roof, and your target is not to feed the grid as much as you can. It's nice if you have too much, you can send it back. But on a rainy day, you need enough panels that you can fill your battery for the night.
As a computer specialist himself, Danny really enjoys the open source nature and flexibility of the Victron Energy system.
Yeah, I was massively impressed from the easiness, from the applications. I had some smartphone possibility with Bluetooth, and this was my fascination, that I see everything what I want, that I can program it what I want. If you are open-minded, you can build what you want. And the idea of Victron was the same philosophy that I work every day. This was the point why I'm impressed about Victron, that they build a system, they build equipment, and we can grow, we can have it small, we can have it big, we can stack it, and there is no limit. And competitors, as I saw or I was researching, there was always limitation or closed sewers. You can do what you can do and nothing more. If I have a system like Victron, I'm not limited in my mind. I program every stops and so on with Node-RED.
Take a look at this video where Dirk-Jan Faber, the one responsible for the Node-RED integrations in the Victron Energy Venus equipment, looks at this farm's automation in much more detail. Such is Danny's fascination with Victron Energy systems that he now provides advice alongside installer Marcus to other farmers locally who themselves are grappling with blackouts and energy issues.
With farms, they have special needs. So we can call each other, hey, this farm have this ID, this farm have this ID, and I can do it from my place, from my office. I can go jump into this farm, check everything, and we can make this programming special optimization for them. And this is very nice because I haven't to drive.
There are even more and more farmers calling my brother to see if they will buy the same system because they hear that, they hear and they see.
In the meantime, Andy expects to recover the costs of the system within 6 to 8 years and is already looking to add further panels to the east and west roofs, along with 2 more MPPTs to boost capacity. The brothers are the 5th generation of farmers in their family. Thanks to Victron Energy, they have future-proofed the business's energy needs for generations to come. Victron Energy systems are helping power homes and businesses all over the world. Our YouTube channel and blog have lots of examples of how we can positively impact clients' power needs, however remote or energy reliant. Like this video, where a family in England built a house only to find they couldn't afford to get a grid connection, so opted to be fully off-grid instead.